Clínico Oligomers for Solution Processing Targeted Enhancement Solar Cells in the Institute of Nanoscience, Nanotechnology and Molecular Materials in the University of Castilla-La Mancha. As you know, solar cells is a device which can convert the sunlight into electricity. And I work with targeted enhancement solar cells. It's a third generation kind of solar cell and are based on blending of an acceptor and a donor. We normally use as donor a small molecule or a co-oligomer based on diophilic rings. And as acceptor, we normally use PC61PM or PC71PM, depending on the donor or the final efficiency. There are three steps to generate the electrical power. After the sunlight reaches the solar cells, the photoactive material absorbs the photons. Then takes place the photoelectric separation and the generation of the mobile carriers. And finally, we have to collect the electrons and the holes at the electrodes. How can we prepare a solution processing targeted enhancement solar cell? So we begin with a substrate with an ITO pattern, like in the figure. The violet zone are the ITO. And first of all, we need to clean up the substrate with acetone, water, isopropanol, and an ozone lamp. Then we deposit the PDOT PSS by spin coating. The PDOT is the EDOT polymer, and the PSS is the sulfonic acid of the polyester. Then we deposit the active layer. The active layer is a mix of the acceptor and the donor. And in this step, we also use the spin coating. And we can use different donor acceptor ratio, different sorbent, and different concentration to obtain a good solubility and a good solution. And then we also can modify the speed of the spin coating to achieve different thickness for the best PC. Then we realize the sorbent vapor annealing process. In the next slide, I explain you the process. And finally, we evaporate the lithium fluoride and the aluminum as electrodes. We normally deposit 1 nanometer of the lithium fluoride to improve the aluminum, to improve the surface of the aluminum, and 100 nanometer of the electrode. The solvent vapor annealing is the process whereby the substrate formed by ITO, PDOT, PSS, plus the active layer, without the lithium fluoride and the aluminum, is subjected to an organic solvent vapor in a closed vessel. And in this process, the morphology of the active layer changes, the reorganization increases, as we can see in the image. And normally, with this process, the final efficiency improves. The next year, we report this molecule, a small molecule, for electron donor moiety and solution processing targeted enhancement solar cells. We achieve a PCE of around 3.85% and a good value of the OPCP voltage, 1.01 volts. And also we study the molecule by X-ray diffraction, and we observe that the molecule forms extended linear networks through a hydrogen bonding between the vinyl proton and a cyanon group of an adjacent molecule. And also we observe that this network are stacking to each other in 3.5 amps of distance. So taking this molecule as reference, we decide to prepare and characterize two new families of compounds. And the first one, we replace the EDOT core by cyclopentadithiophene and distiophene to get more planarity in the molecule. And also we study the effect of the number of active chains linked to the diophene molecule. And in the second family of compounds, we also study the number of chains into the diaphragmoid, and also we change the effector wheel. We use a rodent. The synthesis strategy for all the oligomers is more or less the same. It begins with a corner wash polymer between the RDI of the core, EDOT, the styrofin, or cyclopentadityrophin, and the phosphonate, the corresponding phosphonate of the terpene derivative, without acid change, with one acid change or with two. Then we form the DRDI by a Bechmeyer formulation, and finally we introduce the acceptor group by a Nobenhagen reaction. Here I present the UV absorption in solution of the first family of compounds. As you can see, the maximum wavelength is really good, it's around 650 nanometers, and in all the molecules, the absorption covers a big part of the solar spectrum. For the other family of compounds, the absorption is more or less the same, the maximum wavelength is lower than the previous one, but it's also a good value of around 600 nanometers. For this kind of solar cells. When we measure the UV on field, we observe a bathochromic shift. In this example, I represent the effect of the molecule 1 and 2 in solution on and on field. And the wave shift is of around 100 nanometers. Now I'm going to talk about the result in solar cells for the first family of compounds. Then Nuria told you about the other family of compounds. In this table, I have chosen the best results for the molecule 4, 3, and 2. For the molecule 2, the efficiency was 3.61%, and the heat factor is the best for this family, 60%. For the molecule 3, the best PCE was almost 3%, and the current is good. And for the molecule 4, it has the lowest PCE, 1.72%, but the highest open circuit voltage. And the reason is because this molecule has the lowest ono level. The problem with the molecule 3 and 4, as you can imagine, is the solubility. We have just four or two exit chains, and it's very difficult to find the optimal solution. Here I present the OMO-LUMO levels for the molecules and also for the P61EM. And here we can see that the molecule 4 has the lowest OMO level, and for this reason, the open circuit voltage for this molecule is the highest. About the molecule 1, based on cyclopentadityrophin as core, two exit chains lead to its diaphragm. We achieve a PCE of around 4% and really good current. In the graphs, I present the current density voltage curve and the external quantum efficiency for this molecule. And I present also the difference between no solvent vapor annealing and solvent vapor annealing. And in the table, I also present the results. Without solvent vapor annealing, the current is around 6, and with solvent vapor annealing, increased significantly, and also the PCE. To summarize all the results, I present in the same graph the current voltage curve for all the molecules and also the AUV. For the molecule 1, the best one, and the AUV is of around 40%, and the current is very high, and the PCE is of around 4%. And just to introduce, for the second family of compounds, the best one is the molecule 6 with EDOT, just one exit chain into the diaphragm, and rodanin as a vector. The efficiency was 4.9% and a really high value of the government. I would like to thank to Gisela and the professor Peter Boyle to give me the opportunity to work with him during 3 months. Also to Nuria and the professor Emilio Palomares to measure my molecules in biotechnology and solar cells. Of course, to my research group, especially to Beatriz Delgado, to the Ministry of Education for my scholarship, and of course, thank you very much for your attention.